Live.
We're backstage. Oh, I think we're on live. Well, Suzanne, your timing couldn't be any more perfect right now. We are here celebrating our 10-year anniversary of Bridgeport Pride. We all have our mask on in here.
Completely different. I didn't decorate mine.
But we are here celebrating our 10-year anniversary, and we are doing things virtually as well as having some people come in here live. So ultimately, we will open up our doors, but we do want to give you kind of a little sneak preview before we let the crowd in to kind of see what this is all about. So, Suzanne, you'd like to say anything while you're on the screen?
I just want to say thank you, Ricky, for making us go forward with this. You were the one who said, let's do it. Thank you to Haven Pride Center for giving us our Dorothy Awards. That was another inspiration. Thank you to all the artists and everyone that's sponsored, that's been a part of it every 10 years. Thank you to Steve Gumber, who puts up our exhibit. We couldn't do it without him. Yeah, we're going to hear from all the artists, and we're going to be making videos besides this. There'll be more stuff coming. Our website, citylightsgallery.org, will have a 10-year retrospective soon coming up. But tonight, it's about the party. Go.
That's good. Okay, so with that being said, I do want to give you a little sneak preview as to some of the things that are going on back over here, because we haven't let the crowd in yet. So if you're watching us virtually right now, you got a sneak preview before everybody comes in. So let me just show you a little bit of Victor Pigoretti's work over here. And he's got a lot of digital artwork that we have framed, beautifully printed and stuff. We have a beautiful portrait of Dolores Dégagé, photographed by the Bridgeport Portrait Project. We have Kevin Cox's work over here. So you see a lot of nice portrait painting work done over here. Xavier Alvarez is another artist that we have featured tonight. And then we get to my section over here, which is a nice little, you know, dark looking circus and all acrylic paintings, all for sale for the most part. And, you know, I just want you to take a peek at that, because if you're not able to come here and join us for this celebration, you should at least be able to see a little bit of what's happening. So let me just stand back and kind of show you this entire wall of artwork that we've got on display right now. So those are all my pieces. They're all essentially made with acrylic paint, and they're all kind of this little circus kind of a theme here, which, you know, I thought was appropriate for what I was putting together for right now. But on standby, we're going to walk over to Darron Copeland, who has some amazing what's happening with him. So, Darron.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi, Ricky. How are you?
Thank you so much for joining us again.
Great.
And this is your second, third year joining us?
Actually, it's my fourth year. So.
Really? Okay. Yes, so, yes. You know, you've been involved with this so long, I can't even like calculate numbers anymore, because we're at a 10-year, and you know, that's already kind of a little foreign for me to like even imagine that we've been doing this long. But Darron, I want people to kind of get a close-up of some of the things that you do, because there's a lot of interesting things happening with your work here. So it's all done with needle, thread, fabrics,
yes,
and things like that.
Yes, it's all hand stitched for the most part. Most of the work is hand stitched. It's a what I call textile collage or fiber art. And it's my way of trying to focus on the beauty of the male form and tell stories. I'm a storyteller, and the stories are anything from voyeurism to exhibitionism, and it's an attempt to sort of turn the embroidery on its head and give it a modern twist.
And it's really quite beautiful. It's kind of, it's really a sight to see up close, because there's a lot of things going on in these pieces where you can really kind of, you know, appreciate all the work that went into it, because everything is hand stitched and everything is just done by hand.
Yes, it's a little bit of mixed media, meaning that there's some paint, there's some upcycled materials. Sometimes I find something. I use car seat leather to, instead of buying leather, so I do try to incorporate recycled materials. And it's just, I get a vision, and I just try to take it to the next level.
Awesome. Well, Darron, thank you so much for being here. So again, this is Darron Copeland's work. You can follow him on all sorts of social media, because he's got way more work than just what he's showing here tonight. But while we are heading over to the other part of the gallery, because we do have quite a bit of work here to show you, we are going to go to a little pre-recorded video of some special characters that would love to say some words for you guys that are celebrating here with us tonight. So, Joshua, take it away whenever you can.
Hello, everyone. It's Tinkerbell, and I wanted to wish you a very happy Pride and happy 10th anniversary for Bridgeport Pride. I'm so glad that we can all be exactly who we want to be and celebrate ourselves, what makes each of us unique. Love is love.
Hi, Captain Jack Harkness at your service. I was traveling with my good friend, the doctor, and just thought I would pop in and say, happy Pride, Bridgeport. And I can remind you, it doesn't matter what your preferences are, you're all beautiful to me, and you can all take me out on a Saturday night. So this is, again, Captain Jack Harkness saying happy Pride, Bridgeport.
Hi, this is Isabel, and this big lovable squishy right here is the Doom Slayer. Say hi, Doom Slayer! We wanted to wish Bridgeport a happy 10th Pride, and wish everybody out there a happy Pride. It's important to be loved. And you should be loved. Stay here, everyone. Be who you are. Love.
Happy Pride, everyone. This is Toxic Avenger. New Jersey's first hero of superhuman size and strength. And I want to congratulate Bridgeport on its 10th Pride. No matter who you are, no matter who you love, you deserve to be loved. Stay strong and be yourself.
Hi, Pride Pudding Pops. I just wanted to wish you all a very happy Pride, whether you're dating a clown, prince, a beautiful flower lady, or somebody yet to be defined. I just wanted to be beautiful. You're valid. Love is love, and I am so proud of you. Have a happy Pride. Have fun. Be safe. Wear a mask when you're out in public and amongst germs. And don't forget, be kind to yourself, because you're all you got out there. Love you.
Thank you so much for all those special messages that you provided for us. And now we're back in City Lights Gallery in downtown Bridgeport. And we are standing in front of Carlos Bautista Biernnay's work.
Thank you. Which is incredible to work.
It's incredible to look at. It's another artist that's, you know, doing a lot of things with embroidery and fabrics and all these kind of things. So I'd like to bring Carlos into the screen with me. So Carlos, first of all, thank you so much for, like, you know, participating in this event. And we just like to know a little bit about, you know, what's going on over here and who you are and things like that, because, you know, this is quite an impressive body of work. In fact, this is actually a whole wall of work. So if you get a chance to actually come into the gallery, you'll be able to see all these beautiful things that he's put together. So Carlos, you know, tell us a little bit about what we can look at over here.
My name is Carlos Bautista Biernnay, and I'm a Chilean artist. My work mostly is textile with embroidery or a textile collage. And it's about what happened with me in my life. And I think I just give the news about what happened around me. And I use those things, and I produce this bunch of work.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. Well, Carlos, let's pick your favorite piece right now, and let's kind of like talk a little bit about, you know, what inspired that piece or what this piece means to you, because there's so many things going on over here. So we are being directed to this particular piece over here. So Carlos, if you can stand over here so we can like hear your description and what's going on over here and what we need to know about this one.
This one is a piece very important for me because my father died in an accident, and I decided to recreate a moment with a picture.
Beautiful.
And I embroidered it, and I make another piece, but it's not in this gallery now. Is the compliment with that one.
Nice.
So it's about what happened directly with my life when I was a kid.
All right. Well, we're only giving you sneak previews over here because we would like for you to like ultimately be able to come down and see these things up close, because it's a completely different experience to see them in person than it is from your phone or whatever device you're looking at this from. But thank you so much, Carlos, for participating, and we love your work. And, you know, we hope to see more of what you're doing.
Thank you.
But right now, we have a special treat for you because we do have the mayor's speech from when we did our flag-raising ceremony in downtown Bridgeport. And that's coming up right about now. And we'd love for you to feel like you were part of that.
Thank you, Rowena, Gina, and John, for your constant leadership in keeping us focused and on point. The ceremonies today and last year continue because of your leadership and others. Jim Himes said an amazing array of leaders here come together like last year, which I remember as well. John Harkins back, certainly the Snowball 1969, and gives us a little bit of the history. Joe Graymars, who was a part of that history, certainly amplified it and I think wrapped it into where we are today with these other struggles. Congressman and Senator Blumenthal left, and went down to Washington to take action and be part of federal action, and our congressman is there. Our congressman expressed for himself thoughts and feelings and emotions that we all share, disgust, outrage, rejection of actions that we've seen and the turbulence that goes on in our country as a result, but it's been there all the time, coming to front and center as it does today. So I want to join and echo all the sentiments, the comments, but the tribute as well, John, which you've allowed us to continue for the LGBTQ community in this Pride Month with this flag raising. Joe was honored last year, and we're going to continue the tradition with so many leaders here today. And these events, you know, COVID, we don't do big gatherings. But so many are here. Thank you for joining us from beyond the borders and making this a special day for all of us. I think the best way we can do is to continue to struggle together in solidarity to talk about for the LGBTQ community with this flag-raising, the symbolism of Bridgeport, but to tie it together with the struggles of this nation, the division and the divide, the recognition of what's wrong and what's right, and that we all be on the side of right. And as it goes on, hopefully in Washington, we'll go on at the State House and we'll go on in City Hall chambers as well to join in impactful actions that lead to a better community. Everyone, regardless of race, regardless of gender, regardless of sexual preference, regardless of birthplace, means, or whatever it is that allows us to be different. The beautiful mosaic is referred to by New York Mayor as he described his city. I'd like to think that this city is a part of that, and this great nation that we need to work on, to continue to live out its vision. Thanks so much, John. Good back to you with the
We are back. So what you just saw was during the flag raising ceremony in downtown Bridgeport, which we've done for the last couple of years. And I managed to get some great video footage of our mayor talking before we actually did the flag raising ceremony. But right now, hold off on that video and let's talk to Lester Blum, who's actually standing right next to me, in fact. And we can talk a little bit about his photography because his work is also on display right now. Hopefully you can understand me with this mask on, but thank you, Lester, for participating. I know you came all the way from New York City to be here with us tonight.
Well, thank you. I feel honored to be part of this presentation.
We're honored to have you here. For our 10-year anniversary, we were looking for the best of the best right now. And certainly your photography definitely demonstrates all of that.
Talk to us
about one of your favorite pieces here. Which one would you like to say a little something about? Because it's all really impressive.
In general, first, what was selected for the show is basically about love. Mm-hmm. And what I tried to show was some of the diversity that exists and barriers need to continue to be broken. For example, age, that's an important factor, in the community today. There's a discrimination against age. You have racial discrimination that still exists today. It's all about love. And that's basically what we really want to talk about. Whether it's sexual love, platonic love, it's all about love and availability.
Yes, and all of your photography is very impressive, and it is also all for sale. So if you can make it a point to come down to the gallery Definitely these works of art are definitely things that you want to like see up close, because there's a lot of things that doesn't translate very well on your screen right now, but exactly. All the work is very beautiful. And Lester, thank you so much for participating with us, especially during our 10-year, you know, celebration. This is really
hopefully I'll be around
time
for the next 10.
Absolutely. You know, we did 10 years now, we'll do another 10 years later.
Okay.
So
that's a deal.
But this has been really fun and exciting to have you all guys here. And now we're gonna like mosey on down over to this side over here. I just want to show Thomas Evans' work really quickly. I didn't get a chance to show everybody who's in here because we're moving this along really quickly. But we got Thomas Evans' work over here. And very soon, we are going to go to Don Houston, who is also standing right next to me. So here we'll just mosey on down over here.
Hello.
And Don Houston not only is a participating artist for not only this year, for the last couple of years, but he is also the emperor of the Imperial Sovereign Court of all of Connecticut.
Yes.
So we are privileged to have not only you participating by having your artwork present, but your presence itself
being in front of us.
So Don Houston, thank you so much for being here. Now, let's talk a little bit about what you have presented here with us today, because you've got a couple pieces that are tremendously interesting to look at. So if I can hold my phone the right way, maybe we can see this one piece, which really, you know, it's just pretty explosive when you look at it. And then we've got this other piece here of this guy. I'm almost sure, I think I want to like let you look at it this way so you can kind of feel the motion of this piece. So Don, you do a lot of works with like, you know, water and things like that. So definitely that water has always been a theme of yours. And, and here we go. Now we're both on the screen.
Yes.
That's kind of what it should look like. Or if we can like see you next to your work, that might be more better.
All
so
right.
Don, talk to us a little bit about, you know, what your style is and what you like to paint and, you know, where your sources of inspiration are derived from.
Well, a lot of my work deals with liquids and water usually. So like with this one, I was playing with the lighting and the shading of like a droplet hitting it, like not water really, but like milk almost. And like playing with the lighting and the coloring. And with this one, it was more just about feeling of despair and drowning and just helplessness, basically. Falling headfirst into the water.
A lot of emotion in your paintings here.
Yeah.
And they are on full display here, and they will be up for the remainder of this month into next month as well. And I don't know how to hold this thing because that was even worse than what I was doing. But thank you, Don, for trying to help me. But yeah, all these works are going to be up for a little while. Don's, Mine's, everybody who you met tonight, as well as a number of other artists that are here. And this is your exclusive sneak preview into Bridgeport Pride's 10-year anniversary. We do have two more people over here that I would love for you to like meet really quickly. Just wave to the camera really fast. We got Dolores, the guys, and you know what? We got one of your pieces over here. Come on over next to your work, because we got like a short period of time left. With your piece that you've created, if you want to say something, you got like 10 seconds.
Well, this is inspirational for me. I love peacocks because they're proud, and I think that everyone should be proud of who they are. And all the transgender people in my life are very inspirational, so I put transgender colors into my peacock.
Beautiful. Thank you so much, Marietta, for like participating again. Dolores, we're running out of time, but if you'd like to say something,
well,
now's your chance to like say something
Happy
to the
Pride,
world who's watching.
This is my self-portrait I did.
Oh my God, let's look at your self-portrait, really?
Yes. This is my pandemic portrait. One morning, I was quite startled to see. I've been living alone for 4 months, so all of a sudden.
Photographed during the pandemic.
Behind bars, so I thought that was appropriate.
Well, I think we're running out of time, but Dolores, always a pleasure to see you. We'll talk more after, but we are running out of time over here. Joshua, thank you so much for assisting us with this very foreign version of doing things, but...
Absolutely. And really quickly, let's just make sure we go over the details. So tonight, the gallery is open from 6 to 8:30. There will be a limited number of people allowed in the gallery at a time to maintain social distancing. But it will also be available through August 28th.
That is correct.
citylightsgallery.org. So if you're interested in checking this out in person, there's plenty of time to do so. You don't necessarily have to race over there tonight.
We're going to be here for a couple hours. We're going to be here till 8:30. So if you're in the downtown Bridgeport area, you know where the gallery is. The address has been posted all over our flyers and everything. Come on down. We've got a couple things happening here. We can't have much. We have to have social distancing. We have to require masks. But we are open for people who want to like participate with this. And at 10 o'clock, we have a variety of different ways that you can view our variety show.
So correct. So you're able to watch, you're watching this right now. So if you're watching on Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, you can watch it in the same location. It's also going to be a hosted party to watch it at Trevi tonight, my understanding, isn't there? Or maybe not.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm not sure. We're still kind of confirming that.
Well, so. They may still play it. I'm not sure. But
but be honest, it's also being broadcast in six towns locally on SoundView. So if you have access to that, you can watch it from home.
Right. If you have cable vision, you live in Bridgeport, Stratford, Fairfield, Milford, Orange, and Woodbridge, you can watch it on your public access channel. If you don't live in the district or you don't have cable vision, you can watch it on soundviewtv.org.
Yep.
That again is soundviewtv.org, and there's a button that says watch Soundview TV live. So that's what you're going to want to press, and you are going to be logged on to that website just before 10 o'clock so you can catch the full show. Otherwise, you can catch it as you're watching this because we will be streaming it from this site as well.
And a replay will be available on the New Haven Pride Center YouTube channel if you happen to miss it live. So keep that in mind as well. You can watch it the next day if you go to bed before 10 o'clock or something like that.
All right. With that being said, I think we got all the information out there. We got some people already waiting outside to come in. And if you're going to be around, we'd love for you to join us. And I think that's it. So let's just kind of look over a little video that was put together that you will see the full version of in the variety show. It's a little slideshow of some photographs that were taken during our past 9 years of the history of Bridgeport Pride. So thank you everybody for joining us.
No matter gay, straight or bi, lesbian, transgender life, I'm on the right track, baby, I was born to survive. No matter black, white, or beige, should I I'm on the right track, baby. I was born this way.